Hey everybody, and welcome back to iHeart Board Games here live on Twitch. Today we play Gizmos by Phil Walker Harding and CMON. I am Ronald, and with me I have my friend
Joe
and some other friends here as well.
And Jesse.
Yes. And we are iHeart Board Games Twitch channel. We play board games on the internet for your enjoyment and for our enjoyment too.
Yeah.
And we're glad to see you here, Despeminite, Eve and Diesel. How are you guys doing?
Hello,
Despeminite.
Hola, mis amigos.
Hola, mis amigos.
Evan Diesel.
Evan. Someone needs to send Slivers a message. He was, like, so looking forward to this.
Well, he did say
he's been, like, talking about it crazy.
Well, he should have gotten three emails about it since we had some startup trouble.
Oh, yes. So.
Catastrophe.
Hey, Magritte.
Magritte, hello.
I love the now just be like Ron, etc.
etc. Those are the ones that come up the most.
Yes, exactly. I'm really excited about playing Splendor with you guys. Should be really fun.
Splendor.
Just a little joke, because the internet compares this game to Splendor all the time, so we'll have to see what we think after we play it. We've actually, spoiler alert, all played this game before, so.
Only one time, so we'll see. I didn't get that opinion the first time, so we'll see.
This is what they call an engine-building game. As a matter of fact, I think it's like the most engine-building game that I've ever played.
Ron Citra!
Exactly. I have trouble thinking of another one that's more engine-building than this one. It's a pretty simple game. In the game, we're going to be using these marbles, which are in this little display right here coming out. Don't get the game wet or feed it after midnight.
He's referring to this guy.
Yep. Gizmo!
That scary one.
What he turns into after he gets wet.
Gremlin. Well, this game isn't called Gremlins. It's called Gizmos.
Hey, Whiskey Nick, how's it going?
Hey, Whiskey Nick.
Now watch. In like 5 minutes, Slivers is going to pop into the room and say, I missed the explanation of the rules. Can you go back and say them again?
That's true.
He calls it every time.
Yeah. So we'll be taking marbles from this little contraption right here. And we'll be putting them into these circles, and then we'll be able to use them to build different contraptions, level 1, level 2, and level 3 contraptions. Okay. Thank you, Despeminite. Thanks for stepping up to the plate. Thanks. We appreciate you. In this game, during your turn, you're able to take one of four actions. There's a handy-dandy little player mat here that helps you know what they are. They are file, pick, build, and research. So I'll tell you a little bit about those right now. File. That's when you take one of these gizmos and you put it in your archive. Now, think of the archive kind of like Splendor when you use a gold coin to reserve card. Same thing. You're taking it and you're putting it over to the side to reserve for later, and only you will have access to it from that point forward. Pick just means you take your little fingers and you pick one of these marbles out of here, one of the six marbles that are visible, and put it in your bowl. You're allowed to have a number of marbles in here equal to this number right here, which for all of us at the beginning is 5, unless we upgrade it. Build means take one of these gizmos, or you can take the one in your archive, one of the ones in your archive, and you're going to build it by paying the kind of energy that's listed and the number. So, for example, this one costs 1 energy and it must be yellow. This one costs 1 energy and it must be black, etc., etc. This one costs 3 energy and they must be yellow, like that. When you build it, you're going to put it down in your area under whichever symbol matches the one that's in the corner. So, for example, this is a plus, so it goes here in my upgrades area if I build it. Mm-hmm. And we just played Abyss recently. And the symbols down, the symbology is very similar to Abyss for the costs. And I keep thinking that this means 2 and 1 must be blue. But that's not what it means. It means only 1 and it must be blue. Gotcha. That's what it means.
It'll never split.
This means
off
7
like that.
And it must be 7 blue. That's all it means.
Wow. 7.
Okay. So build, that's build. The last one is research. So when you research, you're going to draw this number of cards. It's all 3 for all of us until we upgrade it. And you can choose from any of the decks, the face-down decks, and you're going to either build or file one of those cards. The other ones are going to go at the bottom of the stack.
Right.
So if you build them, they go into whichever area they match. If you file them, they go over into your archive for later. The game will end whenever somebody has built 18 cards? 16 cards? I'm not good with numbers. 16 gizmos total, or 4 level 3s. So, if someone has 16 gizmos, that includes your starter one, everyone starts with one, the game ends when everyone has an equal number of turns. So Jesse's our first player, you can tell because his player 8 is brown and everybody else is gray. That was handed out randomly. So everyone's gonna get an equal number of turns. So if Melissa builds her 16th gizmo, we're done. She's last player. But if Jesse builds his 16th gizmo, Joe, Melissa, and I will each get one more turn and then the end game will end. So 16 gizmos or 4 of the level 3 gizmos in one person's area. Mm-hmm. Everybody follow that?
Mm-hmm.
You'll get points right here in the corner of each of the gizmos, tells you how many victory points they're worth. And you can also earn these tokens that have victory points on them as well throughout the course of the game. Different gizmos will give you those. And that's pretty much it. That's
hearts.
How you play. As you build different gizmos, they're going to be triggering other gizmos. So, pretty neat. For example, right here, we have one right here. If you file...
How do you play the game?
Bravo! Bravo! Bravissimo!
Encore! Encore! Every time you file, you get to do this symbol right here. That little symbol right there means, can't see it very well, but it means take one from inside of here. That's what that means. And that is not to be confused with picking. Picking is from the line. Drawing from in there does not count as picking. I want to make sure that's clear. And as we go along, we will explain more as we go. If you guys have questions, legitimate questions, what's the earring for? What's the earring for? What's the earring for?
No earrings here.
No one's wearing an earring. Maybe oh, you mean these things?
Oh.
That is where you put your marbles. So this holds your marbles. Mm-hmm. Yep.
And so you don't lose your marbles.
Mm-hmm.
There's a limit to start. 5 marbles. That's it.
Yep. You can have one in your archive, and you can only do a research of 3. But you can upgrade it by purchasing one of these plus cards. Can you lose your...
Cool. Just
Dad, can you lose it? Oh, gosh darn it.
So that's what the beginner card looks like.
Beat you to it.
Yeah. Can you lose your Oh, I see.
Beat me to it.
We have a latency on for your speedy jokes.
But. So, Jesse, you're
going to
be starting us up.
I have a question. It's already been asked in chat. Never mind.
What's that? Can you lose your marbles?
No, how do you play the games?
You're going to choose one of these 4 actions today.
Yep.
Over and over and over.
Which one are you
going
to choose first?
Pick, because I don't have any marbles.
Oh, so I guess that would be wise to pick, huh?
Because you need marbles to build gizmos.
Sure, sure.
Now, the other action you might choose to do would be to file.
Mm-hmm.
If there's one that you're like, oh, I really want that card. I want that card really bad. I don't want
anyone to take
Joe
it.
The snake over here to steal it. Then you could take it
no,
and file
that's
it away.
Regular Joe, he wouldn't snake and steal.
But this is a swell.
Mm-hmm.
Choose a face up and add to your archive. Oh, archive just off to the side.
Off to the side, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Well, that's an old nickname, actually, to Spamonite that I pulled out of the safe over here.
Yeah.
I had it handy. I guess everyone forgot about it, but I brought it back. Sorry, Joe.
What? No, he likes that name.
Oh.
Joe the snake.
Not to be confused with Jake the snake.
All right.
You know who that is?
What game
in the
was
chat.
That? The snake in.
I think it's TOT Wakan, but it had no.
That sounds right. I don't remember.
It wasn't related to the game before.
That's right, Despamonite. You got it. You win our prize, which is nothing.
Praise and honor from.
It's
us.
Melissa's voice on your home answering machine, if you have a home answering machine.
You didn't go over these cards specifically, did you?
No, but I'd be happy to if you'd like.
I just have a question about the black one on tier 1.
Right here, every time you build a blue card, you get a pick action.
That's right.
See the little hand.
Yeah, it sounds pretty good.
When you see that marble with an X in it, it means it's wild.
What does that mean?
So this is an upgrade.
Oh, it's from here.
So this will add +1 to how many marbles you can hold and +1 to how many is your research value. Which is when you draw the face down cards.
So you
can
draw one more?
You would draw one more.
I am simply going to pick, though, because that one you need black for. None of these are black. I can't get it. So even if I took it aside, it wouldn't be very good for me.
If you choose an action, do you do all the cards under it? Okay, no. Not exactly. Potentially. The whole core of this game, the way to win this game, is to trigger lots of actions whenever you do certain actions.
Yeah, I'll take a yellow one.
The engine build.
So he's going to pick.
So what does this file card do specifically? This first one?
Okay, so I'll explain that again. Whenever you file a card, you get to draw one random from in there.
And no looking at the
overhead
camera.
Nice, nice.
I think I like this one right there.
Let me go from the... I hope this is a yellow
we're
one.
We're not allowed to see, so make sure that when you draw out of there, you don't
hold our eyes.
Or just look away.
So it could be that it triggers something else underneath it. So let's say, for example, this is just an example, that I had this card in my array already, which says every time I build blue, I get. And then I build this blue card. So when I build it here, it triggers this, and I get a free pick. And then if I had something under pick, because I picked, if I pick the color that it goes with, I get to activate that, and it keeps going and going and going. And I get to choose the order that they have in it.
I didn't shuffle these cards, by the way.
I did. I shuffled them extensively.
All right. Cool.
So it's my turn now.
It is.
Aren't we having fun? I'll take yellow. I did a pick action. They're not real marbles.
They're plastic.
They're plastic, and they're somewhat ill-formed.
They're you know, Coleman, you're not.
They're spheroid like.
Exactly. Yellow.
All right, back to Jesse.
Yeah.
We all have yellow ones. That's not good.
Isn't it?
Yeah. We might all be going for the same card.
Guess you should have did a
take the red
file instead. No, I think it would have made it cost prohibitive to use real marbles.
It's a chance for you to upgrade it yourself, though.
To marbles made of diamonds.
Also, they're light.
Yeah,
that could have something.
They
to
have little
too.
Bubbles in them.
Yeah,
they're not going to break this little cardboard device.
Right, right.
Speaking of which, I guess you assembled it before we started.
I'll take this.
You guys assembled it the other day.
Oh, we did?
Mm-hmm. Whenever
so I'm going to...
Oh, she must have done it. I didn't do
this,
it.
Right?
Joe helped me.
So you're going to do a build action?
Yeah. So choose one from the face of it.
Yep. Mm-hmm. You start off with a poor, cheap version of the game, and so you can...
And then...
Oh, yes, like in Ticket to Ride.
So now you're upgraded. And the card gets replaced immediately.
Fancy cars and big board and all kinds of stuff.
So now going forward,
so
you can fit
edition
six,
Gizmos,
and you can fit four.
Real marbles.
I want to point out a rule about this game, which is different from other games, and it's about these limits. Mm-hmm. So for example, if I have five marbles in my pool right here, in other games, I will be able to draw a sixth marble and discard one. That is not the case in this game. In this game, I can only have five, and if I have five, I cannot draw another until I spend some or find some other way of getting rid of them. That's the rule. Same for any of the other limits that you might experience in the game.
Roger that.
Roger, roger. I guess I'll take blue.
So
hey, River, how's it going?
I go first. Is there some sort of balance to everyone else? I guess we all get the same amount of turns, so I guess there's...
We all get the same amount of turns, and there is a, fourth or third level tiebreaker, which is the person farthest away from first player. But if you get down to that level,
all right,
you've, really tied it up.
Right.
I would like this card, please. Goes through the upgrades.
Yes, the tie. In a case of a tie, the tie player with most gizmos in their active area wins. If it's still tied, the tie player with most energy left in their storage ring wins. If it's still tied, the tie player furthest from the first player going clockwise wins.
Uh-huh.
There's no card.
There's a new
complete.
Card, which means.
So what did you do? You did a build action.
Yep, I took my yellow marble and went in there.
Great.
I got this one and I replenished.
I love it.
So those converters, gizmos that convert energy into different types and different quantities.
I should also state this is important. You can only ever use each gizmo on your turn once. Mm-hmm. I want to make that very clear. So like, for example, if you build this gizmo, you cannot convert all your yellows into any color. You can convert one yellow into one color per turn. That's it. Mm-hmm. One time per turn.
Now I have an extra marble quantity and an extra archive quantity.
I want to buy that middle card, please.
Okay, here you go. So you're going to build. You're going to build action.
I'm going to take a build action. Spend energy to add it to my active gizmos area.
You're done. Yeah. And the card always immediately replenishes.
Okay.
I'll take the red marble.
And I'll take another blue.
I will take black one.
I'm gonna file away this black card down here.
Okay.
And draw.
Hey, I saw you look.
I'm gonna build.
Is it because these symbols match?
Hmm?
When you file, you get to pick, right?
I'm gonna build this.
Pass the ball down.
We'll get it in there. Do a build action. Build this one right here. There's an inverter.
Switch the music to space. That makes sense. It doesn't, but
all right, Jesse.
It's different.
When they come out with the deluxe anniversary edition. I was thinking in the car on the way here, if this game didn't have marbles in it.
My turn again?
No, it's still Jesse.
Originally, it didn't.
Would it have made as big a splash as it did? If they were just chits, would anyone have been like, oh, cool, gizmos? I'm not sure.
Originally, it was like a sack of cards or something. I forgot what it was. But once CMON got a hold of it, they switched it to marbles.
I do like the little marbles.
I'll take a blue one.
The blue?
Not that one.
Too late. It's been chosen.
I'm going to convert this yellow into a blue. It's been these two blues. To build. This.
Yep, converting. Pretty cool.
To turn in these two black marbles for this card here on the build action.
I'm going to build action.
Replenish.
On this little guy here for one of these.
So you built a blue or black, so you get a thingy, huh?
Yep, he gets a free pick.
Free pick. Let's go for this one.
I'll take a yellow one.
I'll also pick a yellow one.
I will choose a red one.
Remember the first time we played this at Dice Tower Con? Mm-hmm. It was equally quiet at the table. Everybody's doing this.
Where are they?
I don't know.
There was that guy with the accent.
We have to do this.
When I asked him about his accent, he told me he didn't have an accent.
Yeah.
We have to do all this.
And I'm like,
you remember that?
Wait a minute. Where are you from? And he's like, I'm from Florida.
Yeah, that's
I'm
what
like,
it was.
Where? Like 30 minutes down the road. I'm like, you sound like you're from Eastern Europe or something, or Norway. I mean,
yeah,
he had a strong accent. I don't know what kind.
I'm spinning these two to build that middle first thing.
He had a Floridian accent.
I mean, I've spoken to many Floridians.
So these two things for building blue. I guess we'll go with, what does that symbol mean on that yellow thing? Build and file?
Whenever you build from your archive.
Oh, build from the archive. Okay. Let's go with, the red. And let's go with, another red.
So you get two picks because you have two cards?
Two cards, yeah. Mm-hmm. Now I have three cards.
Aren't you fancy-smancy? You're all Floridian fancy.
Floridian fancy?
Yeah, with based your fancy story, accent. Yes.
Oh, okay. Accent aigu.
What is this?
Whenever you build a card with black, when you build a black card, okay, you're going to get a free pick. Okay. Yeah. Each of the different kinds of energies is a different one. So this is fire, atomic, battery, and electric. So that's why it's a picture of a battery, because black is battery.
All right, that's enough.
Okay. I will turn this blue into a red.
Blue into a red?
Wookie, wookie, wookie.
Build this one.
It's electric.
I will turn this yellow into a red. Build this.
Ooh.
And since I built something, I get a free pick. So I'll pick this yellow.
Oh, no more marbles coming out. There's a
hold on. Sometimes you just gotta. Yeah, the rule book says sometimes you need to reach your hand in there and just jiggle it around.
It's good.
Jiggle.
We're good.
So let us know in the chat if you have played Gizmos.
I'm gonna grab this blue.
Or if you've played Splendor. And if you've played them both, what is your comparison?
This has more engine abilities.
I see where they say that it would be Splendor, because in Splendor you have to gain all the different colored gems and jewels in order to then like get the card. So I get that aspect, but that's about as far as it goes for me in comparison.
Yeah.
Eve Van Diesel says he's a Splendor purist. What does it mean to be a Splendor purist? You only play the base game? A spurist, yes.
A spurist.
Look at this.
Is there not a pick?
File it, right?
Engine?
And then we just
haven't drawn any yet.
You want me to draw it? It's random, right?
Yeah.
How many?
Just one.
Whee! There it goes.
Yep, there are. There's some that go under pick. And when you pick, you get a something. Slivers!
Slivers! Hello!
We were just talking about you a few minutes ago. If you don't mind.
Oh, must get the homework done.
Yep.
That means he plays Splendor the way it's meant to be played, with real gems.
Real gems!
Real stakes.
It is okay. We forgive you.
We don't mind.
Yeah.
No,
I'll take
worries.
This one.
I will take this card here.
So you're going to build that? Mm-hmm.
So, to convert, use this blue.
Mm-hmm.
And now I can turn reds into anything. This could be anything.
You can turn one red per turn into something
this
else.
One red could be anything.
Well, Slivers, you've played Gizmos, and I assume you've played Splendor. What is your comparison of the two games? I'm eager to hear.
All these Splendor killers. I'm just like, meh.
I'll pick blue. Go for it.
How dare you pick that
people
blue?
Said that,
pick the yellow.
I should have picked the yellow.
What's that game? Eastern Wonders, not that one, the one before it.
Century Spice Road?
They said that was a Splendor knockoff, but I didn't even see how they were similar.
I don't get that comparison there.
What did you think of Eastern Wonders?
I'll spend one yellow to build.
Until not comment, I spend one yellow.
And since I built the yellow, I get a free pick, so I'll pick.
I didn't mind Eastern Wonders.
And that's that. Right. As far as,
Oh! I should have got a pick. I didn't do my thingamabobs.
Well.
Well, I'll grab one of these blacks, because they would have all been out here.
But then he would have had different options. Hey, Cash Leo!
Cash Leo!
Thank you, Cash Liam, for that subscription with Twitch Prime.
Well,
we heart you.
It wouldn't have been any different.
Are you sure that would have happened?
It's fine.
It's fine. Go for it.
I mean, I'm stuck with picking a black because I know that's what would have been out, and it's two blues up there, so
it's not going to change.
There's going to be an asterisk.
Big asterisk.
The chain of marbles has changed.
Oh, managed nice. To play two of the three Kickstarter games that
I
are
saw
on
those
Saturday.
On Twitter.
It is my turn, eh?
Yeah, because you were just doing a take backsy thing, yeah. So my thing on Eastern Wonders was it complicated a game I didn't think needed to be complicated.
Archiving.
To me, it made it more complicated than I wanted it to be. I don't think it's a bad game. I would play it again. I just would prefer the purity. I'm a purist.
Century Wonders purist.
So I get one
random draw, yeah.
The thing.
Don't look.
She's totally looking.
Is she looking?
She is.
Another asterisk. Yeah. Just the one you wanted.
Exactly.
Yeah. Call to Adventure is recommended for you all to try if you get the chance, because the storytelling would make a cool stream game.
Centruist.
Adventure is out there.
Now would be a good time to let you guys, to remind you that you still have a chance to vote in our straw poll on what game we'll be playing on Saturday for Travis's birthday. Mm-hmm. Right now, there is a very forward-facing winner, but you can change that if you vote, if you don't like the one that's been chosen by the masses. The link is in our Discord. It is a pinned post under the General tab.
And these two. And I'll take Dish.
Alright. And these two. To build this.
Heroes Welcome to a bigger one. Heroes Welcome.
So here, you'll probably want to put them like this.
That sounds really familiar.
I feel like I've heard that title as well. Mm-hmm. Like I've
you're gonna get like a whole
seen
bunch
it on
them.
Something or heard it.
Did you get anything for that?
No.
Okay.
What shall I do?
Be nice to see more pick cards or file cards. I do remember there were file things. No one has them. Nope. Joe, you won this last time you played, right?
Mm-hmm.
What was your strategy?
Get to marbles and then do some stuff. And
then
the time we played it, Dice Tower, you actually won, and Chris played with us as well.
I remember.
I didn't know what was going on too well. So.
I'll pay this.
I remember
this.
What I did there is just built.
And also what
I
was
file, but
yeah. Also what I was doing seemed like it shouldn't be allowed or something like that. But it was a crazy chain.
Oh,
Joe's stat was to slither his way to victory.
Stop giving away my strategies.
Lots of slithering.
Lots of slithering.
All right.
You can. Oh no, you haven't built that yet.
I'm going to pay these.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait. I can't. I can only do one red to something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to grab another black.
I wonder what she's going to do next turn.
What does she want? She wants the three black?
It's in her arc.
Oh, gotcha. I was looking up there. I was like, okay.
Yeah, she's going to build this three yellow.
Yeah. I don't know.
So there's the link there to our Discord. Thanks, Stream Melons, for that. You can go there, go to the general tab, go to the pin post, and you can see the straw poll to help us decide what we're going to play on Saturday. The end of that voting will be the end of our stream on this Wednesday, so make sure you're getting your votes. If you have an opinion for Travis's birthday, he's turning 42.
I'll take that new card that came out.
Of life.
Don't do anything for me. That does make my file a little cooler.
Okay, I'll file this one.
Which means you get a free pull. Shall I help you?
Yes. Next number is...
Yeah, that's just a little joke to Spam, and I have no idea how old he is. I mean, centuries, I assume. It's got to take that long to build up that much bitterness.
For centuries.
Let's see, what am I doing?
It's a geological process in building bitterness.
Oh, God, what's wrong with that?
Looks like you're going for some victory points over there.
Oh.
Is that how you win?
You said and everything on the internet is true.
That's true. Everything you say is fine.
Your hashtag rules, Lauren. People didn't lie to
us. Evan Diesel's birthday is Wednesday. We're playing a really cheery game on Wednesday.
Yes. My birthday was this past Friday. So you guys all missed it. We did have a game night. We played an 8-player game of the Quacks of Quedlinburg.
Please post your concerns in the chat.
Let us know what you think about playing an 8-person game of Quacks.
I was not there for that.
Yes.
Thank you. Yes, we had two copies.
Happy birthday, Dorana. No,
that's four. Two copies. And that's what happened. I was not in charge, and I did not support it. I just want to say that up front.
It's like, we had this.
But I was outvoted by seven other persons, so.
Really? No one wanted to split?
That's what I said to Spamonite. I had two tables, we had two copies, we had 8 willing participants, but the person teaching the game insisted that we play with 8.
I never knew there was an option not to play separately. I just like...
He made it very, like...
But it was your birthday. This is what that's true. Yeah.
I also had never played the game before. I didn't know anything about it, so...
Nobody else had played it.
No one else had ever played the game. So no slivers. You don't.
It worked, better with the one person explaining it.
Yeah. Okay. Right. He did. He explained it to everyone.
I pay.
Because the other copy was brand new, not punched out.
Yeah.
And so.
Da, 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 da.
You messaged me 8-player Quacks. I was like, I guess that's a thing. I didn't question it.
Because it's a game where you play like simultaneous. Travis was there, wasn't he?
He left.
He left. He played one game and then left. Is that right?
What did he play?
We played Salem.
Salem. And he became a witch at the very last minute, right before the witches lost. Mm. And he, I found out. Oh wait, were you a witch?
Not until the end.
I found out that he's the one that caused me to die. He chose to kill me. The other witches wanted to kill someone else. Travis wanted to kill me, though.
His strategy was to harass Ronald, whether or not Ronald was actually the witch or not.
Have one person explain to 7 people and still divide up. Yeah.
I agree with you, Dismaminite.
I'm kind of disappointed now because we were playing in...
And the shots? No.
And the funny thing is, like, I had watched a rules video before the night had started, so I already knew kind of how to play. And so we're setting up the game or whatever, and I'm like, isn't everyone supposed to get one of these resources? And they're like, no. And I'm like, well, could we maybe check the rule book? And so they're like, yeah, we'll check it. No, you don't. Yeah, I checked it later. We were totally supposed to have gotten the gem to start. Everyone was supposed to start with
Ruby?
The gem. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not in the credits.
Bring this person who did this on stream so we can yell at them. That's not going to happen. Yeah, actually, he has been on stream before.
He's been on stream.
Yeah, we're going to leave him anonymous. How about that?
Oh. Is that what we're doing?
Yeah! I don't want people, like, coming after him.
He's okay. When we play 16-player Quacks.
Yes!
But now you can never say that you didn't have that experience. So there you go. You got that.
Take one.
Checking all the VODs.
We played a game while we were at the board game cafe in Texas that I really liked.
Mm-hmm.
It has a very Mahjong feel to
Dragon Castle is the game. Yes. Also by CMON.
I really like Dragon Castle.
I'll take the red one.
It's Mahjong, except you do something with your Mahjong pieces.
If he's ever really on this, if he's ever streaming with us, I will say, oh, and look, it's so-and-so who was the instigator of the 8-person game of Quacks. And then you all can say whatever you want to say about it.
I wasn't there for that.
Whoa, Nellies!
We're playing 12-player Wingspan next week.
Yeah. Can't wait.
I'll pay this one blue to build this.
Oh no! He He's now the Quack Squad.
This is gonna go here. When I build a blue, I get a victory
point. It was a pick card.
He got the pick card.
He got the pick card.
I did. There will be others. Hey, it's the Quack Quack.
Yeah, he's
quack, 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 quack.
What's his turn?
Oh, my turn.
The game actually has nothing to do with ducks, I found out. When I showed duck cosplay. Mm-hmm.
Are the quacks like crazy people or something?
No, they're people who have like fake medicine, like quack doctors.
Oh.
They're making potions.
It sounds like it has somewhat ties to some kind of historical thing there.
Quedlinburg.
Kind of market. Yeah, there's some kind of market there. Yeah,
okay.
Basically, they're chiropractors and people who are like doing herbal medicine and stuff like that.
Chiropractors.
You know,
ladies and gentlemen,
it couldn't have been that bad. You all play simultaneously. It wasn't Cash Liam. It wasn't bad at all.
Ladies and gentlemen.
The only weird thing was the catch-up mechanic, because seven people were catching up with one person, so it gave like. I'm not sure that's how the designers really intended it to work.
Black is a yellow and get that first one right there. Oh wait, that's yellow, isn't it? Put it back. You know what? I'm just gonna pick.
I'm gonna turn a red into a black and build this card. Is that considered right?
I don't know what that is.
So you built a black? Yeah. Yep, so you get a free pick.
All right, so I'll take a blue. Thank you.
It became really interesting in the last round when you're waiting on everybody, because every time someone pulled out one of those ones that lets you draw another and go through your thing, everyone had to stop. So it was just,
it's a bag.
Yeah,
I want to play it.
You're pulling stuff out of the
bag. It's a good game.
Of course, I had like terrible luck drawing stuff out of that bag. There's like only certain ones that'll make you bust, and if you get a value of over 7 from drawing out of the bag of that kind, you bust. My first 4 tiles I drew out of the bag were all the busty kind, and I busted to 8 in just my first pulls. When other people were like going all the way around before they drew their 4 things, I'm like,
thieves all over again.
It is, but it's one I actually enjoy. There was a bit of like mitigation there, so it wasn't as bad. Okay, I'll pay this black to make it into a blue to build this. And when I build a blue, I get a victory point.
So our next 4 streams will be 8-player Altiplano. Because it'll take that long to play.
Oh gosh. And then you guys tried to play Inish.
Yeah, that was something we messed up the rules on that again.
Same person was teaching that one as well, and it was there was some problems, and they were at my house till 2 o'clock in the morning. That's all I'm saying.
Let's see if they're here in the chat.
I've never seen him in our chat before. Well, the sea otter is here though.
Well, that isn't really accurate.
I love sea otters. Oh, it's not. The sea otter's not here. A bunch of people are here that are not talking. Hey guys.
That's okay. They don't have to
look. Press that follow button while you're here, while you're at it.
All right.
They're just stunned at the loss of complete rules.
Right. They're like, I'll be very critical of them.
You're up.
You're up?
We didn't know that. We didn't have the right in-game conditions for Inish, so there was never an in-game.
Wait, there's an in-game now?
Like, is this supposed to end at some point?
Why'd I do that?
I'll take a blue.
Joe's collecting like all of the marbles.
Yeah.
I'm collecting none of the marbles.
We're collecting some of the marbles.
Well, I see some. I should
this one. You messed something up?
Minor. Hey, River!
River,
and
the Spamma.
Seed gifts.
Hey,
whoa! Oh gosh. The music is going to be playing.
There's a generous.
Thanks, River, for that. Well, is it an anonymous gifter for River, to Spamminite, Hardly Adults Game Night, and Splinks?
It's been a while since we've seen some of them here. Hardly Adults comes by every once in a while on game nights, too. So you all have two, count them, two emotes currently. Next month, hopefully it will be three. With lovely, lovely anonymous gifts like this, we will definitely have three.
You gotta change up your phalange dancing.
There they are. If you have a suggestion of what the
thank you guys
should be, let me know.
All day.
GG.
Thanks for anonymous gift.
Is it my turn?
I need to work out my arms. Is it?
Yeah, I got that. A blue.
I took this.
Oh, makes sense. Then I'm taking.
I just played Altipano last week. It was our first play, and it took 3 hours. I'll stick with Orleans.
Cash Liam, I'm on board with that.
Cash Liam, unfortunately, I feel the same way.
I feel
Altiplano is to Orleans as Eastern Wonders is to
Spice Road,
in my opinion. It complicates something it didn't need to be complicated.
I'm going to get that yellow one at the end in the second row.
Well, it didn't really complicate it. It just made it longer with less interaction. I'm going to turn the yellow into a blue and the blue and build my card over here.
Okay.
Melissa.
I mean, I like the idea of it. Don't get me wrong.
Aldeplano?
Mm-hmm. And I love that animal.
The alpaca.
Yes.
See, if they would just put alpaca as an Orleans, and then we would have a problem. So
I'm going to archive this card.
Yeah, we have the... That's the only one we have. We don't have Invasion. We have the Trade and Intrigue.
You can't even hold that many.
I like how it gives purpose to the map.
No, you know, I'll get there.
Traveling. That's my turn. I'm going to... cough in the other direction. Then I'm going to take one at the end, the blue. I'm going to archive it. Or file it, I mean. And then I'm going to take one from here.
Filed in the archive.
And then I will pick one as well.
I'm going to archive.
File it in the archive.
Hand me one.
I need Invasion. The co-op is amazing. Yeah, I've been curious about that, turning that into a co-op.
I'm going to do research.
Ooh. That means draw cards from one of the face-down level decks equal to your research amount. You may choose one to build or file.
He's doing that just so people can see what that actually is.
So I drew three cards because my research value is 3. Two of them are going to get stuck back at the bottom of the stack. The other one I can either build or
place in the archive
file. This one I'm going to build. So this is cost me 1 red.
You have to take one, for sure. Oh, it says may choose one.
That's right. So build that there. When I build a red, I get a victory point and a pick. So I'll pick, I'll pick yellow.
One yellow left before they're all... That. I am going to... Oh, I didn't get the plus folder.
So this is all you can do.
That's all I can do.
Until you build it.
Right. What's that build? Is it a blue one?
Good.
Just take one of these.
What is that?
What is this?
Why is it? Alright, I'm going to take my red and turn it into 2 red, and then I'm going to turn each one of those reds into 2 blacks, and then I'll turn all those in.
That's cool. Neat trick.
For this, and then I get, since I got the black card, I get a pick, so I'm going to take a black one.
Why did you choose black? I mean, when all those different marbles were so many different colors, why did you choose to pick black?
But he didn't have that many. He wanted to...
That's just a little joke because there were only six blacks available.
Oh, yeah. He wanted to do his archive.
That's a joke. Sometimes I'm not good with comedy. I have a very flat affect. Okay.
He's a comedian.
Affect. Affect.
Melissa, it's not a comedian.
Now... Rude. Now I'm going to spin this black one as if it were...
It's comedy.
A yellow one. And I'll build this.
Build
right here. And when I build a yellow, which is what I just did, I get a point and a pick. So 1 point.
Oh, and sure, a pick. It would be nice to get these little point things.
Well, I mean, you are
you have points on your cards.
Yeah, the cards have them.
All right, I'm going to use this one yellow as though it were two yellows and grab that card there. Thank you.
Okay.
And that made it easier
it
for me.
It goes to this pick area.
It sure does.
And I don't think I had anything else. Nope, it's not a red or a blue, so. That's it.
Cool. I'll build this thing from here. So it does not, oh, by the way, I can do all that. It will not trigger these blues because I'm not building it from there. I'm building it from here, so it does trigger these two, though. But like we were saying in the rules before, this would not trigger because it was the same action.
That's right, that's right.
So, there's a confusing rule in there. Anyways. So I'm going to pick.
You may use the effect of a gizmo on the same turn it is built. However, it cannot be triggered by the same action that built it.
Yeah, Phil Walker Harding, the only other game I could think of that he made that we really like. I mean, we like a lot of them. Just the only one that came to mind is Archaeology, the card game.
Oh, I love that game.
Which was one of his first ones.
So you get two free picks, right?
Yeah, two free picks. So I'm going to take... Put that notes out to
my copy has definitely seen better days, but it was a cool backstory to how we got it.
It came to us from a garage sale.
It's definitely seen better days, but
got it for cheap.
I love that game.
I'll convert this yellow into a red. Oh, maybe I won't.
Maybe you will. Maybe you won't.
Yeah, I'll convert it into a red. Sure, why not? Put this in play. Whenever I build a red, I get two free picks and a point.
Emotap.
And Sushiko. I love Sushiko too.
We haven't played Baron Park.
I have.
And Cacao.
We saw it in the store. Didn't get a chance to play it.
Gingerbread House last year. That's right. He came in with a bunch of stuff last year.
Oh, and I...
Yeah, Sushiko.
I picked up this blue one.
That's his image on Twitter, actually.
Okay, so is this an example of when I would be able to use this? You may use the effect of a gizmo on the same turn as built. However, it cannot be triggered by the same action that built it.
What built it?
So, this... I did a build action to build this card.
Mm-hmm.
And then one of these cards over here, this one,
let you
triggered
pick.
A pick.
Yeah.
So that...
I think it would trigger,
triggers this. So I get to pull one out of here.
Anyway.
Okay.
My turn?
You guys let us know in the chat if that was incorrect. Or if you're on YouTube, the comment section down below is your friend. Also, hit subscribe while you're down there.
All right, I'm going to use this red. I'm going to use a red as an anything to grab this here black one. To put in the upgrade.
What's the folder space there?
Yep.
Did you reserve that blue thing?
What? Yeah, she did. And now she can actually hold seven marbles.
My.
So she's going to be going for blues, if you're curious.
Yeah, I'm a little curious. Well, let's file away that center blue item there, please. And when I file, take one out of here. And I get to pick one. Let's pick a blue. What? What's the matter?
Blue.
Blue?
I hope you get enough of them before somebody gets 16 cards in their display area.
Yeah, no, I'm going to be working this whole game. Please.
You're jumping from like ones to three. That's crazy.
I should use this blank. Pick up this blank card. All right. And build that. And I get a pick. So I'll take a blue.
Sorry, Melissa.
Bunch of blue swipers.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Melissa.
It's okay. I'll just pick up something else with all these blues because there's so many blue options on the board.
That's when Gizmos got real.
When Gizmos gets real.
It's all right.
Next time on Behind the Gizmos.
Maybe I'll go for a research and hopefully draw something good.
Yeah, totally.
I'll pay one blue to build this. Whenever I build a blue, I get a victory point.
Just going down the victory point lane.
All right, I'm gonna do research and I can draw three cards.
Cheryl! Balangi dance. Woo-hoo. Thank you, Cheryl, for that subscription. We heart you 8 months.
8 months.
That's serious. She boogie. I love it. Boogie down
now. Boogie, boogie, boogie. All right, I'm going to do a research, and I'm going to pull from this deck.
I don't know what she's doing.
Why are you taking so many? You just need three.
One, two, three. Just
her research number is like 20.
I don't know how to do that, like what she just did.
I know.
You slash me, and then you type after that.
Oh.
Oh.
It's like, you know.
Cool.
Like an action.
Right. Haha! I'm gonna archive this card, because I can archive.
Yeah,
yeah, three. You sure can.
I mean, you know you don't get the points from those. Alright. Right. Wonderful.
Now I'm gonna be taking all my yellows.
Yes, I am.
I can't win for losing. First off,
he has four marbles already.
Then all my yellows.
Hello?
Ah, he's doing it to spoil me.
No, I'm not. I
can't even use it.
I don't know what he's doing with all those different colors.
Everything. Yellows are everything.
It looked like you had fun in Houston.
Houston.
Yes.
Yeah, we traveled around, hit up all the board games.
Houston.
Some of the board game stores, yeah. But most of the board game cafes. They only really have two of note.
Yeah, I really love Tea and Victory.
I'm curious which one you were trying to get parking for, because we had the same problem at all the other stores we went to, especially Asgard Games. Has like six parking spots in front of it, and we just drove through neighborhoods and
parked on the street.
Yeah, like, I guess we won't be staying long. Yeah.
And I'll build this card.
But yeah, Tea and Victory, it has very
lots of parking.
Very nice, like open, lots of seating.
Since I pick a yellow one, I get
board
to do a
games
free
are
one
easily accessible, have people to help.
Yeah.
And it's got nice teas and beers on tap, like in this big wall, like specialty stuff. It was really nice.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to play Dragon Castle, which I really liked. Now I want to get that. I'm going to be looking for it. A dice tower this year.
I'm gonna do this.
The flea market.
These two can be whatever color I want them to be, so they're gonna be two reds. To build this thing. Whenever I build a red, I get one victory point.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I get two picks. So for my two picks, I'm gonna pick a red. Which lets me get a free draw. And then I'm going to pick a black, which lets me get a free draw.
Mm-hmm.
Telling you, I've got the lemon jalopy of the engine building around these parts. My poor little thing is like one of those putter mobiles.
Putter mobile?
Yeah.
It's a little engine that could.
It's your turn, little engine.
I'm getting this yellow.
Good for you.
I don't know if you noticed, but right after he took a yellow, the next turn was Joe. He also took the yellow. I just want you to know, no, everyone is against you. Except me.
I get a bonus.
I'm on your turn. I'm on your turn.
They all have these reasons. So they have reasons. I need this one.
I'm taking this. I mean, I'm building this. And so that'll be a blue, a blue, a blue.
A one, a blue.
So when I build from there, I get to pick four.
Well, now fancy that.
It's pretty fancy. So let's go one, two, three, four.
There's another blue one.
And more yellow.
Yeah, see, I'm trying to help you.
Likely story.
It is likely story.
While it's very I sit likely. Here in my puttermobile.
Yep. The other place we went to was Coral Sword. We actually did find one of the six parking spots in front of it.
Yeah.
There we played Tokyo Highway.
The thing that I saw the huge difference between that place versus Tea and Victory was the lighting.
Yes, it was very dark in there.
It was
they painted all the walls black.
Okay.
And low ceilings.
And maybe they're trying to make it like coral, like under the sea kind of feeling. I don't know, maybe.
Coral's red.
It turns into a red.
But maybe like in the water,
you know. I don't think so.
I don't know. I think
it's
just build this.
It was a very big contrast. I could sense a contrast of like dark versus light of Tea and Victory.
And does any thing happen?
No.
But I will say that that's the first time I ever had St. Arnold's version of root beer.
Yeah, I'll do research.
That was very, very close to our Abita when we have around here, and I enjoyed it. It's very good.
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. Researching.
Yep, I'm gonna do this one. It's gonna cost two black, so I'll spend these two blacks. Put that there. Whenever I build a black, I get a victory point. Melissa?
I'm gonna pick this blue.
I'm gonna build that six red. I don't get any special bonuses for red.
Okay.
I'll take a yellow and I get to pick out the top. Thank you.
I'll do this. Convert these two blues into reds. So that's three reds. Build this here.
And do they have a guide for icons in there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's this one.
Yep.
Whenever I build red, I get 1 point. And I also get two picks. So I'll pick a black. Which when I pick a black, I get a random draw. And then I'll pick a red. When I pick a red, I get a random draw.
They don't specifically say anything about building from the archives in regards to color. Is that specified somewhere in the book, I guess?
What do you mean?
Like whenever you build, for example, if I built a blue one from the archives,
mm-hmm.
But these don't trigger.
Don't they?
Oh, they would? I haven't been triggering them. I've just been triggering the archive one.
This type of effect triggers when you build a gizmo of the specified type. Blue, for example.
So, oh, wow.
Even if it comes out of the archive, you get it. The bonus.
Oh, okay. Well, I just shorted myself a couple.
These ones only happen whenever you build something from the archive. These ones happen when you build something of the specified color.
Anywhere.
From where they came from here or from the archive.
Or from research or from... Okay. It doesn't matter where they came from.
Last time I played this, the Dice Tower, we played it the other way. That's why that's still in my head.
I mean, someone who's has access to the internet could look that up and let me know if that's incorrect.
I mean, that's why when I played this before, it just seems... There's so much to remember and so many ways. It seems like you shouldn't be getting that bonus, but you're getting everything.
Right. Okay.
So
it's your turn. I'm grabbing this. Well then, I shorted myself a bit.
There we go.
It's okay. All
right.
It is what it is. Is it my turn?
Yeah. My turn.
Let's archive this blue card here.
This one?
That's the one. When I do that, I draw here. And I'll draw here.
Slivers is triggered.
Me too.
I'll take a blue one.
I'll do research. Yeah, I get to look at 5.
Ooh, I get to look at 6 if I ever did that. Strange that we played that at Dice Tower that way, though.
I don't even remember. That was so long ago.
Yeah.
You could look it up if you want. Or someone else.
No, that's okay. I mean,
Did you get to Nan's Games and Comics?
Nan's Games and Comics. I don't think we did. I don't even remember it coming up.
No. Maybe because it didn't specify something with board games? Maybe.
Yeah, probably.
Maybe it's because some more comics?
It was at Asgard.
I'll do this one.
That's where it was. We circled the block.
Yeah,
blocks around it twice, and then we went across the street and parked.
3 black.
I don't understand.
That's crazy. It's like, and
when
there's
I build a black,
plenty of
I get
space
to
in actual
take
stores.
One victory point.
Where do you expect these people to park? Do they just randomly walk from the neighborhood? Is that where the majority of your people are? Because there's not enough parking for the amount of space in the store.
It seemed like every place on that street didn't have parking, though. All
right, so I turn in these 2 yellows. Each one of my yellows count for 2, and I'm building this one.
Each one of your... No, one of your yellows counts for 2. You can only use these once, remember?
Oh, so 2, 3.
Great.
All right, where does it go? Wait, this
converter.
Place. Yeah.
Make sure things there.
And I built a yellow, so that doesn't do anything.
All right, well, I'm going to build this from my archive. And since it's blue, I'm going to get to pick twice. And since it's a build, I get to pick 4 more times, so 6 picks. And that's 1 blue for that. So let's go with 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, the internet thinks we're right.
Yay! Okay. We're right!
So I'm going to turn this blue into a red, and then I'll turn those 2 reds into... I mean, that 1 red into...
I'm sorry, I have 16 things on my board.
What does that mean?
Game's over.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Melissa should have had the last turn. You shouldn't have gotten
the last
turn.
Oh, so I didn't get a turn. Cool. I don't know, this is going to make it to you two. Hey, Dragon's Demise.
Well, that just one person took a turn that shouldn't have.
Well, my board's all messed up.
Oh. I'm sorry.
Well, we can play a second game. We can redo it. We'll play game 2.
That's up to everyone here.
Okay, so now...
You had 1 jump, Ronald, 1 jump!
I was looking up a rule because Disfaminite didn't look it up for me.
Disfaminite.
Instead of counting my cards.
Yep. Apologizes.
Okay, so anyways, let's go to the end of the game. So end of game scoring is based on the numbers that you have on your cards and also the numbers that you have on any tokens.
Well, this bunch of nothing.
And anything that's in your archive, just keep it in your archive. It's not going to count for any points. The spin when I was using the head. Okay, it's still out. I was using my head as well.
Oh, all right.
I just made teenager years.
Just made? Oh, wow. You think if you played again, you'd understand better?
I would do better things to get more stuff.
You say that.
But you've played this before.
I just played it the one time, and it's been a while, so the engine building part was like, plus I'm parched. I want some water.
I only have 32.
25.
I'm 17.
13. I made teenagers.
That means I won. But Jesse didn't play his right.
That's okay. So we got to play again.
But I still won against Melissa and Joe.
That's a strong score, though, so who knows if that would even made a difference.
All right, let's try again.
Honestly, I probably only shorted myself like 5 or 6 ball things there.
So GG.
Geez.
Slivers, are you still here?
Where's the fireworks?
No fireworks.
What? No fireworks? It's too many asterisks?
Fireworks.
One asterisk.
You get some fireworks.
This gives you good game.
Yeah, exactly.
So Dragon's Demise, you guys just came out with a YouTube video.
You shot it.
All right,
I'm
going to
get some water while we
Get reset. I'll take one as well, please.
I'll take a vodka tonic.
Very different from your Twitch stuff. Because, you know, it's actually produced. I was going to ask if that's the same Dragon's Demise, but I can't imagine there'd be multiple Dragon's Demises.
Melissa stopped.
That's the one.
On her way to the water. to kiss cats. Okay, so we need to get the other purple cards out of the box.
What? There's more?
I forget.
Oh.
Same thing last game. I forget how much things I can do. And I'm just like, oh, I need a blue one. But I had a way to get a blue one. And I was like, just completely oblivious to it until it comes back around. Like,
exactly, Cheryl. She was going for water. The kitty stopped her and said, excuse me, I need you to pet me, please, and pick me up. Because, you know, cats love to be picked up. And that's what happened.
The cat said, be a shame if somebody tumped over all those marbles. Yeah. I mean, jumping on stable.
We do a bunch of Twitch stuff, but also come out with those board game bistro videos. They just take so long to produce.
I know, that's why we just mostly do this, I would say. We do have some productions, but not many, because, no. It just takes so long. A lot of us have background in film or acting. But still, we're like, we want to play more games. How can we play games if we're editing a video? But.
So this is a little bit behind the scenes. 20 of these purple cards get taken out of the game every game. So they're randomly not in the game. So you don't know what you're going for on that.
I wonder what they do. I know what one does. I never get to use it, but. Oh, I mean, what you've done so far looks good. I mean, I would have guessed you did. Although, you should have used real binoculars at the beginning. That's my only note.
What?
In their YouTube video. They're looking at birds, but they're using their hands.
I love it! How cute.
I'm a fan of props.
I like the creativity.
Yeah. All right. So, look at me. I still have this.
Fan of Carrot Top.
Does anybody else want this?
Put your finger on my thumb.
Oh, yeah. Prop comics.
Oh.
Put your finger on my phone.
Me! I get this thingy.
Oh. Okay.
Put your finger on my phone.
All right, Melissa. You may go.
I'm going to do better this time.
Oh my gosh, I cannot believe we're playing this again at 8:15 at night.
Right.
I'm so sleepy.
Brett.
Are you really?
I didn't sleep last night.
Surely 7:50.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. That's
really, I didn't sleep last night.
Go me! I'm going to do better this time.
Go you. Go you.
I'll take...
Cheryl said, like, go me. Go oh. Melissa. Yay.
I'll take
Why don't I get any support? That's okay. Oh, I don't need any more support.
Jesse J is my fan club. He's not here today.
There we go.
And Jenna is Melissa's fan club. And it's also apparently Cheryl.
Yay!
Who's Jesse?
I believe in you, Jesse, says Whiskey
there
Nick.
There we go.
I believe Whiskey Nick and Jesse should
go
play that boat game by themselves. Melissa, are you going to take a turn?
Oh, I am. Ah! Jenna's my fan club.
Adam Kraftsburg. Hey, Adam, how's it going? Welcome to iHeart Board Games. We hope you enjoy your stay. That's not awkward at all.
I'm gonna
You had
use...
someone else at game night the other night, huh? Someone we didn't recognize.
We had a bunch of people at game night
that we didn't recognize.
To grab
Who?
This card.
Did you come out your game night or not?
Adam? Adam's been here before. Adam from Maryland?
Oh, he was at your game night?
Mm-hmm.
Who was sitting next to Camille?
Oh, Sean. That's one of Randy's friends. He just moved here from Metairie.
I had no idea. You told me that. That's why it reminded me, because I saw Adam. I was like, wait a second.
Dragon's Demise, watch out.
Dragon's Demise, you're being stalked. Let's go for the blue pick thing. Could be fun.
Blue pickety pick.
This?
Yeah. Adventure.
Adventures out there.
That's what I hear.
I'll take this one.
Melissa took the card I wanted. Like a rat think. Like
somebody's watching me.
What?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Stalking.
That's a thing.
Yep.
I'm gonna file this over here.
Ooh, going for the big one already.
Which means I get a free pull.
Okay, I'm grabbing this yellow.
Wow. Yeah, I guess it wasn't that expensive. And it's pretty darn good.
Well, hello, Zuckerberg.
What does that mean?
Which one?
The one that just came out and replaced? What Ronald took?
Yeah, what it means is, in last game, that card would have scored me a number of points equal to how many I made from those.
Mm. Oh.
Count up how many points you've made from those. This card is also worth that many points. It doubles.
Would have been really
those.
Good for what you did.
But I wouldn't have been able to build that.
Oh, the end of the game triggers with either the person who gets the 16th card or four of the level threes.
Yep, so either four of these purple cards or 16 cards total in their display. Everyone gets an equal number of turns, though, so since Melissa was first, everyone's going to get a turn all the way around to me, and then we're done.
You took your turn?
Yes, you pulled the yellow.
I'm going to pick, which gives me a one random.
I'm going to take the yellow, which also gives me a random.
I don't want any of this junk.
Research.
I'm gonna research.
There you go.
Our cat seems to be watching Gizmo. He likes a little Gizmo.
I'll build this one for a red.
There you go.
Adam, what language is your mother tongue?
That's the color? Yeah, that's all right. I've heard that.
What language would you be speaking if not English?
German.
Oh, German. Ich bin Ausländer und spreche nicht gut Deutsch. Ich verstehe nicht, was Sie sagen. It's the only two sentences I know in German.
Ah, German. Guten Tag.
I'm from Germany overnight shift.
Oh, yeah, that's true, because it's about plus 8 hours from here, so 4 a.m., roughly.
All right.
Doch du verstehst, was ich sage. I don't speak German, I'm sorry. Ich verstehe nicht, was sie sagen. It's your turn, you must take your turn, then speak German.
One, yes. Okay.
One little yellow, I'm going to build this one. And when I do that, I get a point. Right? Correct?
Or is what's the point?
Correct?
Uh-huh. Yeah, you built a yellow. Uh-huh.
Yay! It's
yellow. All right, let's build this one.
Too bad Jesse J's not here. You guys could like speak German together.
Oh, she's trash.
Your turn.
I always feel like somebody's
watching me. Have no privacy.
Gizmo me.
Ooh. All right, I haven't built this one. Which means when I file something, I get a pick.
Yep.
Okay.
I love that.
Make it brighter. It's kind of dark in the background.
I'll build this.
Yeah, we'll watch it. You're streaming.
We oh see dear! All. But were you watching me earlier when I was at my house? Because I felt kind of creepy. Like my nickname is out of three words.
Adam,
Crafts, Verg.
Verg.
I will never tell that was you. Melissa, you go after me.
This is almost like a best in this way too. Hmm. The pearls.
Hello. I think it must have been inspired by Abyss plus Stratego. What's the other game?
Stratego.
Ah, oh, Stratego.
No, we made an Abyss reference earlier.
So. Yeah, but what was the other game this is compared to?
Oh, Splendor?
Splendor, not Stratego. Yeah.
Stratego.
I mean, the translation is Atomic sense. Power Dwarf. I love that.
Have you ever heard of a game called Telepathy?
It sounds familiar. I think you would like it. Go ahead.
It's like a. I'm gonna pick.
Cross.
Let's pick a blue. Then I can pick one.
Oh, I should have known that because I have a person already that's Dunkeldorf. Dunkelberg, which means Stark Dwarf, is Dunkelberg.
Hmm.
Hmm. I will build.
That guy should have known Dwarf was Verthus. I've seen a Dark Dwarf.
A Dark Dwarf?
Yeah, so it's Dunkelberg.
I'll do a pick.
Melissa. Look at that. She has a point.
I have 1 point. Yeah.
No, you don't. You have 3 points.
That's a point more than Ronald. All right. That's a point more than me.
Mm-hmm. She's also first player.
True.
But we've all had an equal number of turns.
I'm going to pay this Joe one has three. Here.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Grab this card here.
I like the art. It's really, really cute. Mm-hmm. There are several artists for this game. A bunch of them. Giovanna Guimarães, Hanna Cordoso, and Fernanda Montoni for the card illustrations. The cover art was done by Saeed Jalabi. Okay. The game design director was Eric Lang.
I picked a red one. And I
do
need
love an Eric Lang.
A random.
Well, he didn't design it.
Do
it
was make it a game, and he.
Ronald's turn.
That's me.
That's me. Yeah,
Mario.
You always have to build something extra.
I plan on it.
What's up, iHeartWorldGamePoint?
Gumbo. Gumbo is here on Twitch.
Is that BJ?
That is BJ.
Hey, BJ.
Hey.
You made it over here.
I can't believe you're here.
We went to Anubis Games the other day just to check it out on the way back from Houston. wow, that thing's far away from the interstate.
It is.
I'll do a pick.
Out there.
Gumbo is delicious.
Board Game Gumbo will be streaming with us on March 30th. Right here for our all-day stream.
We'll be at the Southern Board Game Fest in Lafayette, Louisiana. If you are local to Louisiana, please come join us at the festival. Yeah. It's really fun. We were there last year. Yep. Yeah. Oh. If you're from like Colorado or something, just make a little short drive to Lafayette. It's not far.
It's a little far.
I know. I want some gumbo.
Jesse makes a good gumbo.
I'm gonna research.
Use the monorail next time.
For three.
Use the monorail. Well, we were coming from Texas way, and we were just passing through. But we'll be sure to use that monorail next time.
That'd be good. Monorail.
I guess living here, it's like gumbo is so typical, you know? Like, we can eat gumbo any day. But I guess living somewhere else, it's not like that.
If you do the research thing and file it, do you get to do the file stuff? Because it says you may...
Yeah,
I would think so, yeah.
Yep.
So I'm building this for three blue. Go ahead.
Damn, that marble tower fills my brain with so many ideas to make a tower with many different mechanics to transport the marbles and a big acrylic tower with a black basement so you can't see in which order the marbles come out. I love it. Ooh. Make one and send it to us.
You have to be able to reach into the top, though. That's part of the game. That's the only thing, though.
I'll file that one. Just to file it, I get.
Adam Craft.
Thank you, Adam. Follow, we heart you.
I get a random one.
Random one.
And then I get a pick one, which I'll pick the yellow one.
Yellow.
And since I pick the yellow one, I get another random one.
Random.
Les éléments roulent.
Mm-hmm. Yep, we get to wear a little microphones.
They don't do that with the R in French, by the way.
Well, I'll pick a red. I'm extra.
Is distracting?
Isn't it on the roulette?
What in the world?
Like, we gotta wear super those stuff, extra.
Right? Oh, we're not that.
I put not lots of rah.
Yeah, you're used to it.
I am?
Well, you're on stage.
Oh, it's not like that.
No. It's very Melissa. Different, but having a mic.
I hate wearing a mic on stage.
You do it on the side or the top?
No, the side. It's like taped to your face right here.
I mean, you could tape it if you want.
I don't need to.
Okay, I'm going to use this red to grab this here yellow because my reds can be anything.
Mm-hmm.
And then I build a yellow. Which means a good point.
It's going to be an experimental day, that's for sure. Replenish.
That will be our first time streaming on this channel from somewhere other than here. So definitely come and show us some support on that day, March 30th. Tune in. Even if you see some strange faces, tune in, say hey. There will be designers and other important people in the hobby. So show them some love on that day. I need to win the lottery, then I can build all my ideas. Oh, I just wish I had ideas.
You have said that before.
Yeah, I don't really have them.
I think you have more than you think.
Okay.
More ideas.
They're there. You gotta dig deep. Dig a little deeper.
We will be streaming from the Southern Board Game Fest, Dragon's Demise. That's in Lafayette, Louisiana. It is a local convention. This is their second year putting it on. It's kind of a smaller convention, but it's gonna be pretty cool.
But it's grown from last year.
It was really neat. They had people there teaching kind of gateway games, nice library of games to choose from.
And they had the library there, the actual like library in Lafayette, displaying like what their 3D printers are able to do with board gaming now.
They did?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they had the library there, and they have a 3D printer at the library. That was very nice. 3D printing has really done a lot for board games.
Do you like Gizmos? I like Gizmos.
Oh yeah, I like Gizmos.
Melissa.
I'm terrible at engine building games.
Yeah, I feel like my other strategy with the builds would have been better, but we didn't get as many this time. Like, Melissa has one, but it's not.
My strategy from last time is way better than this time, because last time I had a strategy, and this time I'm just rando.
It's one of our friends in the board game group has a 3D printer and... Jerry's made a very nice dice tower. It has where the dice can come out of either side.
Yep. So, Slivers, what are you going to print us?
Oh, yes. Oh, that's right. Slivers has a 3D printer, too.
Spin this as 2 and pick that middle thing.
He has to make us a 3D printed Ronald.
Oh my goodness, what for?
3D printed Ronald.
For that thing.
Oh yes, that thing.
Ronald, yeah. Will you teach us, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, but the thing is, you got to design it. Like, you got to actually draw it.
Right, right. I don't want anything. That's I was just kidding.
You...
Send me the links of what you want.
That's pretty big. Yeah, so you got to go to the Thingiverse or something like that. 21
to 25. Oh no, what would we want?
I would use what game was this that red as a yellow.
No, it's going to be like a big, like the Siri. Siri, can you bubble?
Oh, oh right, right. Yeah. That's right. We need to find a toy that looks like Ronald.
A toy that looks like Ronald?
Yeah. Like a little... I'm sure there's a toy out there we can find.
Yeah, I mean, I basically look like the Ken doll, so...
There you go. We'll just tear the head off of a Ken doll.
But tear the head off!
Ouch! I've been watching Sabrina, so...
I'm gonna archive this card.
Okay. Jesse?
Oh, back to me. Let's, let's pick one of these, which lets me draw from here.
Ah! 3D print of Travis Voodoo Doll, maybe put it on a creepy island or something. That's where he is right now, actually. He's on a creepy island.
Turn that black into a blue.
I will say, Slivers, I do love dice towers. I have two of them now that are 3D printed. One for the very first year we ever went to Dice Tower that was 3D printed by Patrick. Can't remember his last name right now.
Havert,
yes. He 3D printed a set of them. I got that my first year. Jerry made us one.
It's like a very modern voodoo doll, 3D printed one.
I want this yellow.
I got any more of them reds?
Everyone should dress as Travis for his birthday for Saturday's stream.
Unfortunately, I will not be here on Saturday.
I mean, I'm already basically dressed as Travis. I look like him.
I have church that day. And speaking did not of know which, ahead of time.
You guys can vote on what game we're playing on Saturday. There is a straw poll in our Discord. You can go there and click on it if you haven't already voted. And help us decide what to play for Travis's birthday.
Oops. I do plan on still kind of popping in. I will be here later in the...
I will pick...
In the afternoon.
Pick a blue one?
I mean, get name tags and name everyone Travis. Unfortunately, Cheryl, that is not one of the games on the straw poll. If it were, it would have...
Pick a yellow one?
It would have won by
a random one.
Huge scale. The thing about it being his birthday is he got to pick games he actually likes, you know, because it's his birthday. And he doesn't like that game. Just like many, many, many other games he doesn't like. Okay, so enough about him since he's not here.
We just need to make a new straw poll.
All right, Adam.
It'll be concept. And then two games of concept.
Yeah.
It'll be fun. It's a gift. It would be our gift.
I'll pay this red to build this blue because red counts as anything for me.
Mm-hmm.
And when I build a blue, I get a point.
Melissa.
The yellow.
Yeah, you're picking. So that red shows up. Good.
You're welcome.
Yeah, that's why you did it.
It's all for you.
So I'm going to build that blue thing at the end. Which allows me to pick two. One. One on here. I'll go for yellow. Okay.
I'm going to turn these three in to build this.
I should have went for the
black. Why is there an X above that seven on the top?
Because
there
could be any color.
That's so kind of a rainbow of colors.
Ridiculous.
That's the new straw poll.
Concept.
Something involving concept. Game that begins with C and ends with oncept. Or Concept. I like this one. Game that begins with E, ends in...
Melissa.
Oh, I didn't work on that. Oh, there we go.
Oh, I'm building this card out of my archive.
All right.
Which goes on the build.
Three votes for a game that begins with C and ends with concept.
Okay, and it's costing me the three yellows. It is a card, a yellow card, so do I get this?
Yeah.
Does that work? Okay, so 1 point for the yellow. And
all right.
Is that just a whole thing?
Oh, you're done.
I am done.
Let's do, let's build something. This thing. This is red. We can get a pick at least. Let's build this thing for the red, which lets me pick something here. Let's pick a blue. Oh wait, if I pick a blue, I won't be able to get the things. Because I can't go over five at all.
Choices, isn't it?
I would just stop. There's no replacing, right? You said that at the beginning.
If you have five, you can't draw anymore.
Yeah. Yep. Dims some breaks.
Dim something.
Everyone picks your vote.
Either way, I'm gonna have to pick something. So let's go with the blue. And then I'll pick something.
I vote for one that starts with C and ends at onset.
Yeah, that's the one I picked.
Yeah.
Oh, that's his winner so far.
Alright.
Concept is
I'm going
winning.
To file this. So I get to...
Post that on the Discord for us.
Do what?
I get a random.
I have it on this machine.
And a pick. So I'll take a black.
I need to put it on this machine. Alright. So it's Rondell. Rondell. Ron Speeton. Ron Catastrophe.
Here's two black to fill this one. So we can give a catastrophe. Unless it's your turn.
What shall we get, Gail? What do I need? What do I need? I'll take the blue marble.
She's doing a pick.
All right.
Got the blue one.
Gonna research. One, two, three. Mm-hmm. Yep. I have to build something, so this is it.
You don't have to build anything.
Well, you could archive I have it or five you... of these things. I need to get something out of there. Which spins one of them, which is pretty good. Go ahead.
When your one yellow counts as two yellows.
Right, no, I'll take a yellow.
Counts two.
Ah. And I get a random.
I'm going to do a pick. Melissa?
One black marble, please. What I really want isn't coming out.
There's research so much, again.
There's so much red on the board, and there's no red marbles.
Who's taking all the red marbles?
I see who's taking all them red marbles there.
I only have three. Joe has three blacks, and there's four of them out. This does not have any bearing on that.
Likely three. Story, says we. All right.
Down you go. All
right. I will
So that was another yellow place? What was that? Yeah, it was yellow. I don't get anything for yellow places.
So I'll take this black and turn it into two black, and then I'll turn one of those into a yellow and mix it with this yellow. And so I get to keep the black. And I'll build this.
Why do you get to keep the black?
It's, one goes into two, and then one of those makes another yellow. And then so I have another black left over. Am I going to keep that?
I don't think you get leftovers.
I don't think so.
You don't get to keep it?
I think it's theoretical.
Theoretical?
It's a theoretical two.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you get to make any change.
Right, you can't change.
No change.
Wait, why did you... What How are you trying to get to?
Oh.
Two yellow.
Well, all I you could have to do is convert this one black into yellow.
Yeah, I did that, but I was trying to get a...
He was trying to get
a change for it.
Oh, I don't think you could do that.
Post it wherever you may post it.
So you get a free draw, don't you? Or no, I guess not.
No, not for that.
All right. I'm having trouble seeing Ronald's engine this time.
There isn't one.
He's got the puttermobile today.
Oh.
I have a slight puttermobile.
I made a grave error earlier. I will do some research.
This researching business sounds pretty good. I might have to go into the researching
field. I did it because there were no yellows out. Like, yeah, if you have a bunch of marbles you need to spend, research makes sense. Alrighty.
I'm going to build this, which costs one yellow. This is a red. It's going to turn into a yellow. Whenever I build a yellow, I get to do a pick. I'll pick this.
All right, I'm gonna research four cards. One, two, three, four.
Just like I did.
All right, got a couple options here.
You got four of them.
I'm gonna build this card.
This card, all right.
Cost me one blue.
Okay.
These two blues are going... I mean, this is two blues. This is a blue as well. I'll buy that blue on row two. And this is a blue card, so it's going to allow me to pick twice. I'll pick the blue, which allows me to pull two from back here. And then the other pick will be, I suppose it'll be a yellow. Ah, I should have done black. Oh, I didn't do it. Go ahead.
I'll turn this into a red.
I'm currently at 11 cards. No one's wondering. Was it 16?
Guess I'll put this in. Build this. When I build a red, I get two picks. So I'll pick a black and a red.
That's a lot of black and red cards out there.
Yeah. Alright, I'm going to research again.
Yeah, that might be my future as well.
You liked it, huh?
I like the research.
She like the research.
I mean, I'm just...
I'm going to archive this
don't
one.
Don't have those
Is
cards.
That okay?
Okay.
I'm going to archive this one.
What do the numbers mean on the back? Is it their potential cost, I guess? Yeah, that's what it kind of looks like.
Potential cost.
I'm going to research...
Ooh.
Here. One, two, three, four, five.
Big money, big money, big money.
Well, I just want choices, that's all. Looks like I found a choice.
You can always file it if you don't have anything to build.
I'm going to build this one for my yellows, not my blue. All right, Joe.
Okay, I'm going to file this one. Should I get a random one?
Random marble.
And then I get to pick one, so I'll pick the red one. And then I get three random ones, but since I can only hold six.
So two?
So two random ones.
So many marble options over there.
Well, he's running with it. Gotta beat last game's score, which was 17 or something like that.
At 17, yeah.
How you doing now? Probably more than that.
I don't know. Probably close to that now.
Yeah. I'll just pick.
You're 15.
I pick.
Going to research. Stack 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on, big money, big money,
researching fools, this game.
Yep. I'm going to build that. I'm building this for two blue, which this is. So building a blue card gets me two picks. Let's pick a blue. Gives me two from here. And let's pick black, which gives me one more pick. And that's it.
All right, I'll take that black. And that becomes two blacks. And I'll build this. I'll do a pick.
All right, I'm going to build this for my archon. It costs me one yellow, which when I build it, it's a yellow card, so it gives me... It came from the archive, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is two random picks?
No, two picks.
Picks.
Oh, two picks. Okay, cool. And then it gives me the point, and then another pick. So three picks total?
Yep.
Yay, I get to pick three. Must choose wisely.
You must.
Okay, black can be anything, red can be anything. So that's for sure. So black can be anything. Red can be anything.
Mm-hmm.
And then another red.
Ocho loco.
Researching this stack.
So much research!
Okay, I'll just look in.
You say that now, and then you keep building things every time. Like, now I think I'm going to build this.
Oh, yeah, I am going to build this now. So I'll build this one. It's yellow. This will be 1, 2, 3, and then these will convert into the others. 4, 5, and it's yellow, so I do get to pick one. That's about it. Let's put these back. Let's pick a blue, which will allow me to dig two up. Joe's turn. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 cards.
All right, I'll go here and get four.
Oh. So, Melissa,
mm-hmm.
How's it going?
About the same so far.
Was this play 2 of 4? He was 2 of 4.
I think so.
I think I'm about par right now.
And I guess it would play pretty much the same with any amount of players. So if you want,
well, there wouldn't be as much of a contest for the cards. Same as with Splendor.
True. It's the same layout, though.
Alright,
it's interesting that that number doesn't change.
I get a random.
Random?
And I get to pick one. And I'll take the red one.
Which will get you? Anything? No?
It would.
Yeah, it's a peaceful up.
Yeah. I'll fill up, yeah.
Okie dokie.
Now, the thing I've been trying to do since I started the game.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
Build that for 4. I never should have taken that. It has ruined my entire game. Apparently, red was the most popular color that everybody else wanted also.
I didn't get many reds. A 1, I think.
Okay, I'm going to research 4 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, I built something red, so I get 2 picks as well.
Welcome back, Adam.
Welcome back.
So you guys, this Wednesday, we'll be back here playing the Grizzled. We hope you'll join in for what will surely be a lively stream.
It'll be our first black and white episode.
Saturday, we'll be back to celebrate Travis's birthday. We're going to play the game that you choose based on the straw poll. Right now, Dead of Winter is winning.
I'm going to pick this one, which cost me 1 red.
Thank you, thanks to that gifter.
Anonymous gift subber.
Alright, I'm going to use the black.
So, 1 week from today, we'll be playing the other Azul game. The one with the stained glass. The stained glass of Sintra, or whatever the heck it's called. I've never played it before, so I'll be very excited to try it out.
Wait, what?
You haven't played that one with us?
Nope, you guys keep refusing to play with me, so I have to schedule it on the stream that. In order to get it played.
That's not true, they're not winning. It's a game that begins with C and ends with Concept is winning.
That's like an alternate universe straw poll.
Segurada?
No, this is Azul.
That is interesting, though.
The stained glass of Sintra.
We should have a stained glass day.
We have played Segurada on stream.
Oh, we have. With 3, though.
It's the people's poll.
Because that was a long time.
The people have voted very much in favor of Dead of Winter, actually, to Spamonite. There's 15 votes right now for Dead of Winter.
Yes, I got this little card.
Researching?
I built this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on.
So if
can you blame them, Ronald, for not playing with me? That's not very nice.
So if what I pick a yellow, a I get a random?
You can no longer do that action.
Oh, it's 7 points, that's why.
Wow.
So, file if I pick a yellow, I get a random.
Yep.
Interesting.
Yeah, I'll take that.
No use for yellows.
I haven't filed this whole... Well, that's not true. I have filed, but not much. Let's do this. So for 4, 1, 2, 3.
It doesn't matter. On Jesse's next game, turn, he's going to finish the game. And since you're a first player, you're only getting 1 more turn.
Oh no! I better pick a card. And quick!
I'm not going to finish the game. How am I going to do that?
Don't you have 15 cards?
Oh, I bought a blue card. So it... Well, that means I have to buy another one. I probably will. Yeah. Let's take a blue. Which would be 2 of these.
Anytime Jesse's going to end the game, he says he's not going to end the game. And then proceeds to end the game the next turn.
And then let's take, I guess, another blue. Or if I get a yellow.
Is this all one color?
Any color.
7 of any color.
Okay. But it's only worth this doubled.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Go ahead.
So it's useless to all of us but Melissa.
And I only have 3 marbles, so.
No, I was going to think it was 7 points, but it's not 7 points. It's that.
That's, yeah, whatever that is. Would have been great for Ronald last time. But even
I mean,
that
I,
was tough
I did
to get.
Good. I got a good score last time, I would say.
Yeah, I mean, it was
37
to let that be worth, like, a lot of points. I don't know. It seems difficult.
I've been a generous.
Look at this.
What the heck is that? Oh, it's upgrade. Plus four.
So, a lot of marbles in your spot.
I fear my end is drawing near, so I'll just get that. Since I have these
forms. The other option would be like research and hope you find something.
I mean, that's pretty perfect for what I had, so. Mm-hmm.
Right, I'm grabbing this one. Goes in the build area.
Hi from Dice Tower West. Oh, just home. Just home from Dice Tower.
Yeah.
Vidger, how was it? You say it was great, but tell me all the details.
I've seen many pictures.
I've seen pictures as well, yeah. I really wish I could have gone.
What was your favorite game of Dice Tower West, Vidger?
Because I'm researching this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Give us the highlights.
What is all of this? I guess that's...
I might be on the vlogs for Spiky.
Oh, right. Spiky that's bastards. That little spiky grab game. What is this thing?
The number of points is equal to the number of marbles that you have in your bowl.
Oh, specifically what you have in your bowl at the end, I guess. Which wouldn't be very much. Because I've got to spin them all to play that
People are so friendly, and the Bing Bong crew were there, and great. Of course, we love those guys. The Brothers Murph is who Vidger's talking about. If you're not familiar, go over and give them a follow here on Twitch.
No, you can't do this anymore.
No, you're right, I can't. So I guess I gotta play...
You can either spin some marbles or you have to say no.
I guess I gotta say no because I can't afford any of these. The cheapest one's 5, but that's black. I don't have anything. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is what I can afford. Because I can't turn yellows into anything. What a bummer.
The video logs, Ambie and Tom were recovering things. Well, more than them, a bunch of the community. Cool. I wish we could have been there.
I didn't do anything.
You think you archive one?
I can't.
He can't. He's not allowed to archive anymore.
Oh.
He gave up that right whenever he sacrificed his children to the demons.
You think I'd be able to archive them? That's a different game, can't do a file.
But I thought filing is...
File is putting things in the archive.
It is archiving. Filing.
Oh, yeah, it specifically says build or file, so I can file. You're right.
There were at least 10 people recording things. Oh, yes. I'll have to go check out the Dice Towers YouTube channel.
Yeah, that'll be a lot.
While you're there, check out the iHeart Board Games YouTube channel. Yeah. And subscribe. I want to go to the Spiel in Essen. Yeah. I would love to go there.
Okay. Oh,
I'll take a yellow.
We'll be at Dice Tower Con in Florida. And we'll be at Southern Board Game Fest here on Twitch.
My wife's excited to maybe do Dice Tower Con in a few years. Vidger, it's so fun. It's really fun.
Yep.
And we're there.
It'll be our our 5-year anniversary this year for...
Yep. What is Southern Board Game Fest? It's over in Lafayette, Louisiana, which is about, 3 hours from you?
Too bad.
March 30th.
March 30th.
All day in Lafayette.
9 or 10 maybe. And yeah, it's an all day board game fest, just about playing games. And it's all to benefit a local outreach program. So
I did a pick.
It's all good stuff. And we're going to have some people from that outreach program on the stream as well.
And Cheryl's at Dice Tower. So that's another exciting thing about Dice Tower. Cheryl's there.
Alyssa, you can go ahead.
I'm going to pick this yellow so that then I can have
a random
second pick.
Not a pick, a rando.
Oh, a random, that's right.
It was his wife's first con. She had fun, so that means I can do it again. Nice.
Yay!
I'm just going to buy the 5 out there because I know I can afford that. 1, 2, 3.
I got addicted to conventions after going to Dice Tower Con. It's like so much fun. So, give them a Google, Cheese Viking. Southern Board Game Fest. They're pretty reasonably priced, and nice people. It's a good cause. And we'll be there streaming all day.
Yay!
So the game is going to end on my turn, because Jesse has four of those brown cards. It doesn't really matter how many total he has now at this point, because he's got four browns.
So it just hit the same number, too, the, whatever the requirement was.
16.
Yeah, so it's 8, 9, 10, 16. Yep.
So he hit both in-game.
Yep.
Yeah, Cheese Viking, you could come in the night before, stay in a hotel in Lafayette. Yeah, there's lots of good food there. Lots of good food there. Yep.
If you've never been. If you want to drive 4 hours, you can stay here in Baton Rouge. We have space.
I'll do...
This is your last turn.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. There's not much... I got yellow and blue, and there's no yellow or blue cards. Or there's one blue card.
Well, you could look in there and do research.
Yeah, no, but I'm trying to think if there's... I probably don't have enough to get... All those are single color mostly. So I'll do a research in the twos.
You get four.
We have cats, no kids, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotta be okay with cats.
How was Teen Victory?
I can't believe really you live in Houston. You haven't been there.
Nothing.
Oh no, he's allergic to the kitties.
I always have to warn people because some people are allergic to cats.
All right, I'm done.
I used to be allergic to cats.
Oh, you got to play Wingspan. I love that one. That is definitely in my top list of like the year's worth of streaming.
No, I'll just build. I'll just build something.
TM Victory is wonderful.
I really
wish we lived next to it.
I'll build this.
When you get a chance to go over there, they have
two pulls.
They have all the like the drinks that are in the little spell spigots. Ah, someone's.
Whoa, Adam! Thank you for that monster tip, Adam.
You.
Oh my gosh, Adam, thank
really
you so much. Wow, that's so
Adam
nice.
Grafsdorf.
We really appreciate that.
That's a game.
You.
It's an atomic dwarf.
Atomic dwarf.
Power dwarf.
Power dwarf. Yes. This game has atomic power in it as well, but the game is actually now over. So we're going to just add up our points. He says he liked it, but it dragged a bit with four.
I like it with four. It really depends what people get out.
Yeah,
I can see how the birds can stack up to where it does drag.
There was an article about the designer. I had seen it actually before you posted it this morning. I was like, oh, cool.
Yes, Adam, is there a game that intrigues you that might be something we should be on the lookout for? That we could...
He has access to all sorts of German games and stuff.
Expansion pack with birds from other continents coming for...
That makes sense, because they were all like North America.
She's developing two more games, one about butterflies and something else.
So now we're counting?
Yep, I have 18 points.
Yes, Cheese Viking Games. I had some very nice... you had a really nice tea when we were there. They had
Melissa's busy chatting, so I'll help her out.
You said it was very good.
Is Melissa not counting?
Nope. What's going on here?
5, 10, 15, 17. Melissa, you and I tied.
Yay! I did better!
Oh, no, I have 18.
I still did better!
He has 19.
43.
What?
No! It's
like when I told you.
We've been blowing up the water!
The game was pretty close for
three
of us.
Yeah!
This is like the first game.
17,
18, 19,
43.
What happened? Somebody was not playing alone. Didn't get the memo.
So that is how you play
Gizmos.
You know, I knew what to do this time. Like, I mean, as far as getting the things that I was earning.
I did better. Yay.
So, you guys, let us know.
Dragon's Demise is local to DC and is played as the butterfly one.
Oh. I can't wait. I really like that bird game, whatever it's called again.
Wingspan.
Yes, the bird
game.
Tons
of egg generators. That's the middle one, right? The middle row?
Yeah.
And that's usually a good way to go. The top and the bottom. I mean, top and the next one.
Aristia?
There's only two players. Aristia.
Still look into it.
Yeah, we have lots of two-player games. A lot of the games behind Joe.
I've heard of Aristia before.
Are two-player games.
I'll have to look into that one.
Yep.
I don't know anything about it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Ooh. That's one of Adam's favorites. It says Dragon's Demise.
I'm gonna look that one up.
Mm-hmm.
Aristia. Pretty well known
Aristia game.
I'm surprised you guys haven't heard about it.
Oh, you know?
Bird eggs. We ran out.
Oh.
They talk about it on podcasts all the time.
But you ran out of bird eggs.
We're definitely going to look that up.
Yes, definitely.
Descent or Massive Darkness. I've played Descent, but not Massive Darkness.
Yes.
I don't recall playing Descent with the iPad, but Ronald's convinced I did.
He did play it with the iPad.
I don't think I ever played it.
You played it also with the iPad and then proclaimed, you know what, we'll talk about it off the chat.
Oops.
Now, I remember
I'll tell you what happened.
With Ronald as the DM, games. We played
that
two rounds.
Like ages and ages before we ever played with the app. The app didn't exist
so
whenever
many
I did
ages
that.
Ages ago.
So that was Gizmos, you guys. We will be back on Wednesday to play another G game, The Grizzled. And then go on to our Discord and vote for what game you'd like to see us play on Saturday. If a lot of people don't vote, it's probably going to be Dead of Winter with expansions.
Starts with a C and ends with onset.
And then don't forget, next Monday we'll be back playing Azul, the other Azul, which is Azul, the Stained Glasses of Syntra.
We'll be playing concept to tell our moves in the actual game. So each person will play a concept game to say what they're about to do in the actual game.
I like that. I like that idea. That's good.
There'll be no speaking other than we'll each have our own concept set up.
I wish there was a way we could like prank Travis that he would arrive here and concept was set out on the table and you guys could all witness it, but we would like then have to spend like the next 45 minutes setting up Dead of Winter because that takes a long time to set up. Yeah. 12 player quacks. Yes. Please replace the game pieces of Dead of Winter with concept pieces.
Oh, we should put like one concept piece just right above the board and see if
like
he
put
notices.
All the zombies out and then like the question mark. The
yeah, question just like mark, in the middle like, of it somewhere. Just see if he notices. Be like, what is that zombie there?
So, is Travis getting birthday spankings on stream? He might get spanked in the game. It is a cooperative game, but there is sometimes a traitor. We like to stack the deck with the traitor. Let us know what your habits are. We like to play with one more card than there are players and include one traitor card in there, so it's a very good chance that there will be a traitor amongst us, unless it's Melissa, and then she refuses to trade. So, she won't be here, so...
I will be around, but I won't be coming until late. So,
we love to spread the board game love to other channels on Twitch. So we are going to head over to another board game channel here on Twitch and make sure when we get over there, spam those heart meeples and let them know that Heart Board Game sent you. So that maybe in the future, if they ever decide to raid, they will raid over to us and spread the board game love back to us.
Yeah, and just a shout out. Thanks again, Adam, for the awesome tip to us and our anonymous gifter for all those gift subs given earlier. Thanks so much.
Yeah, thank you guys. We're here for you. We do this because of you. We know you guys have fun. We have fun doing it. And it really helps us out when people like whoever is doing those gift subs and Adam, when you guys help us out, that really makes it a lot easier for us here.
And if anyone is interested in being a mod here, please let me know. Because on that day, that big day that we're going to have, like the 12-hour stream, I would like to have some mods
around.
Because I'm going to have so much on my brain. So
very small, compact game.
You can post it in the Discord or send a message or whatever
Dystopia.
You want to do. What?
Dystopia?
Dystopia, to be on lookout.
Will do. Dystopia. Yes. Alright, so we're going to head over to... There's a new... Is this a new streamer? I can't tell. Yeah, new streamer. They only have 28 followers, so that's cool. J-Dog. They're playing House of Danger. Remember when we did that?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, we sure did.
Nice. Well, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks, guys.
Whiskey Nick, Slivers, Vidger, Cheryl, Adam, Dispatcher Knight. Anyone else who's still around? Cheese Mikey Games! Anyone else who's still around the chat? Thanks for being here today.
Yeah, I don't know what act they're on. I just know they're watching chat, so that's a good thing.
Oh,
and they're new, so I like that. So bye-bye, we'll see you next time!
Good night.
Bye! Bye.